Alrighty, welcome to Championship Night for the 518 LMRO Sim Series, and we'll start things off with the More to Music Adult Prepared Heat Race number one. How the heat races were set up, not by random draw this time, it's determined by average finish in the feature races. So, best average finish gets to start on pole, and all the way down to the worst. So Noah Dwister in the 30 and the 23 of Draven Farnham on the front row, Nathan Orman and Harley Shepard row two, Kyle Wolford and Dustin Chapman will round out the field in row number three. Green flags in the air, heat race number one is underway. As we head into turns one and two, Noah Dwister, who clinched the championship last week, he's gonna take off like a rocket off corner number two. He'll pull away going into turn number three, and looks like he'll slow down just a bit to make sure he's good. And here comes Nathan Orman on the inside through three and four. Dwister will lead lap number one. Orman underneath the 23 of Farnham. Farnham gets a run on the high side through one and two, but Orman says otherwise through corner number two, and he'll have the two spot as we go down the backstretch into turn number three. Harley Shepard trying to fight off the number 11 of Kyle Wilford through three and four. Here comes the 24 end of Nathan Orman. He's looking for the heat race lead off corner number four. Can't quite make the inside work that time by as Dwister's holding strong for the time being. Orman right on the bumper of Dwister as we go off into turn number two. And now Wilford's going to challenge at 627 Harley Shepard. That's position number four on the line, but Harley holds him off. Dustin's going to... And what a move Harley just pulled off. He went from the high side to the low side through the block on Kyle Wilford there. As Dustin tried getting around the 11 of Wilford, couldn't make it through three and four, but he will happen make it happen through corner number two as he's trying to make the high side work. Here comes Harley Shepard and then 627. Going to look to the high side of Draven Farnham for the third spot. Meanwhile, Nathan Orman up front underneath the 30 of Dwister. We go into turn number one. Nathan Orman going to look for the race lead. He has it off corner number two. New race leader is going to be Nathan Orman as we head into turn number three. Noah Dwister is going to say otherwise on the high side in turn number three. Can he get the lead back? Yes, he does. But who's going to lead this lap off corner number four? Too close to call and give it to Dwister by nearly inches as we go into through turns one and two. Nathan Orman trying to make the bottom work. He's so far got it to work, but Dwister's fighting hard on the high side, making it stick as we go through three and four. As we're going to make it now four laps remaining in this heat race, and it's going to look like Nathan Orman will lead by a bumper as we go into turn number one. Three wide behind them with Farnham in the middle, Shepard up high, and Wilford down low. Wilford looking to make it fifth of third in one shot. Can he make it work as we go down the backstretch as Harley Shepard backs out of it? Here comes Kyle Wilford in the 11. He'll take over the third spot now as we head up corner number four. Wilford up to third. Side by side still going through for the top two right now. Dwister up high, Orman down low. Who's it going to be as we go into turn number three? Orman checks up through turn number three as Dwister gets a huge run on the top side. Orman gets the better run off the bottom of corner number four. He will lead with two laps to go. So putting Dwister back to spot number two. We're going to go three wide once again. Instead of Harley this time, it's going to be Dustin in the three wide with Draven and Kyle Wilford. Draven's going to go to the bottom as Wilford was in the middle and Dustin was in the down low. Draven up high. Wilford in the middle. And Dustin Chapman makes a three-wide situation work as he moves up to third. White flag in the air this time by as Nathan Orman comes off corner number two. He'll pull away from the 30 of Dwister as we head in turn number three for the final time in this heat race. It's going to be the 24 end of Nathan Orman picking up the heat race win. Noah Dwister will pick up the second spot. Third is going to be Dustin Chapman, Harley Shepard for fourth, Draven Farnham fifth, and Kyle Wilfred will round out the remainder of your field. So up next will be two heat races for your 518 LMRO Predators. Alrighty, heat race number one for the 518 LMRO Predators. And again, all classes tonight are lined up based upon the average finish in the features. Obviously with the Predators, prepareds and modifieds, they will line their features up based upon the heat race results. Anyways, Aaron Rakoske, the 33AR, and the 20R of Tiersa Rakoske will make up row number one, and then Ava Rakoske in the 9R, and Tanner being the 428T round out the field for heat number one. Green flags in the air, we are underway. A off corner number two. First time is going to look like single file freight train going into turn number three. Nose to tail, and never mind as we come off turn number three. And it's going to be Aaron Rakoske leading lap number one. But here comes Sister Ava to the high side through one and two. She's going to look to take the race lead through corners one and two. Aaron prevails that time. But here comes Ava on the high side. Gets a huge run off corner number two. Tanner B moves up to the three spot, getting around the 20 yard of Tears of Rakoske. And here we go. Side by side through three and four. It's going to look like Aaron will lead that lap as we complete lap number two. Ava on the high side, still looking for the leads. We go through turns one and two. Tears are trying to get in the third spot back from Tanner, but couldn't make it work as we come off corner number two. Aaron still trying to hold off the 9R of Ava Rakoske as we go through three and four. He still holds her off for the time being, but Ava's giving him a run for his money as we go through turns one and two. Ava might have the high side working here as she has the lead off corner number two as Ava takes over the race lead going into turn number three. Ava's trying to hold off the 33 AR of Aaron Rakoske, which, by the way, Aaron could clinch the championship for the Predator division last week after the Predators had 20 features. So it's all going to be based upon where everyone else is going to finish in the point standings. Ava Rakoske continues to lead the charge going into turn number one, halfway in, five down, five to go. Aaron Rakoske sits there for the two spot. He's getting on the bumper of the 9R machines. We go off corner number two, down the backstretch into turn number three. Tanner Bean has checked out from third, and the 20R Tears of Rakoske sits quietly from the fourth spot. Here comes Aaron once again on the inside. He'll take the race lead at the lines. We go into turn number one. Ava responds back in the high side through one and two. She takes the lead back off corner number two. Down the backstretch, heading into turn number three. Ava's trying to pull away from the 33 AR of Aaron Rakoske as we come off corner number four. She will do so that time by, and we will have three laps remaining. She pulls away more from the 33 ARs. Aaron's trying to get away from the 428T of Tanner Bean as Tanner tried to get on the bumper of the Aaron Rakoske machine, but couldn't quite make it stick as we come around corner number four. Ava still holding strong for right now. She comes off turn number two down the backstretch. She'll be looking for the white flag as we come around turns three and four. One more time around four. The Wonder Woman, Ava Rakoske in the number 9R. Heading into turns one and two, final time. She'll head off turn number two as Aaron's trying to hold off the 428T of Tanner Bean. If Tanner has anything for him here in the final lap. Off corner number four, Ava Rakoske picks up the heat race win. Second will go to Aaron Rakoske. Third's going to be Tanner Bean, and Tears of Rakoske rounds out the remainder of your field. So more Predator heat race action will be coming up next. Here we go, heat race number two for the Predators. On pole for this one in the 32, that is Karsten Diamond. To the outside of him in the 55, that is James Carroll. Row two, we're going to find the 14 of Chase Fisher, and then the outside of him is going to be the 24R of J.L. Rakoske. So another 10-lap heat race for the Predators, and then our modifieds with their two heat races will be coming up after these Predators run their heat. Racing for heat race number two for the Predators. Heading into turn number three, first time side by side for second and third, but it's going to be Karsten Diamond coming around for leading lap number one. Karsten leads the first lap. Chase Fisher now moves up to spot number two, putting James Kerr in the 55 back to third. JL watches from the fourth spot in the 24R. So you go nose to tail through the backstretch going into turn number three. Chase Fisher is going to try to sneak to the bottom. Karsten Diamond kind of throws a block at him. So he's going to back out of it for now as we go into turn number one. Still nose to tail amongst the fields. We go into turn number three. Karsten Diamond still continues to lead the charge, but Chase Fisher, does he have anything for him this time? And Karsten tried throwing the block, but realized Chase Fisher's right there that time for sure. As we go side by side down into turns one and two. Chase down low, Carson up high, and Chase will have the lead by half a car down the backstretch. But Carson will get the run on the high side going into turn number three. And here we go. It's going to look like Chase Fisher will lead lap number four. And side-by-side battles starting to shape up behind them. James Carroll has to deal with the 24R of J.L. Rakoske. J.L.'s going to look underneath and can't quite make a stick off corner number two. Carson Diamond's going to go way up to the top side, and three and four can't quite make it work as Chase Fisher still holds him off for the race lead as we are halfway in. Five down, five to go. JL's trying to see if she can get that third spot away from the 55 of James Carroll. She's going to go way up towards, drifts way up on the high side and through three and four. Had to check up there to make sure she didn't spin out or anything. But here comes Carson Diamond. He's going to try to make sure the 14 of Chase Fisher doesn't get away from him too far. But Chase gets a huge run off corner number four that time by and creates a bigger gap as we go into turn number one. Three laps remain for this Predator heat race. Chase Fisher continues to lead the way. Carson Diamond sits there for second. Third is the 55 of James Carroll, but on the bumper is the 24R of J.L. Rakoske sitting in the fourth spot. She's going to look to the inside in turn number three. Going to take the third spot away off corner number four. Can't quite make a stick, but still side by side going into turn number one. Two laps remain this time by. J.L. is going to look for the third spot. She does going into turn number two. And Chase is going to come around turn number four. He'll look for the white flag one more time around. Off turn number two, Chase Fisher will go into turn number three, final time, and it's going to look like the 14 of Chase Fisher will pick up the heat race win. Carson Diamond will sit there for second. Third's going to be the 24R of J.L. Rakoske, and the 55 of James Carroll will complete your field. So now your Lindsey Giagni State Farm Insurance Modified Heat Races coming up. And now two heat races from your Lindsey Giagni State Farm Insurance Modifieds. As tonight they will have a 50-lap finale. And here we go on pole for heat race number one. It's going to be the 36 of Kaylee Johnson to the outside of him in the 60 machine. That is Yancey Zimmer. Row two is going to be the 81 of the Stieg and the 4 of Scott Sitterly. Row three will have the Punisher, Chris Bachman in the 69 and Harley Shepard in the 627. Taz Taylor in the 61 and Art Van Hosen, Mr. Mofast in the 07 to round out the field. Green flags in the air, we're underway. Off turn number two, down the back stretch is going to be Yancey Zimmer shooting out like a cannon on the high side going into turn number three. But Johnson's right there on the bottom as we go through three and four. First time it's going to be the 36 of Kaylee Johnson leading lap number one. Right there for second is going to be the 60 of Yancey Zimmer, but can he hang on from the 81 of this D? Yes, he can off corner number two. And Scott Sitterly in the four is going to try to get the third spot away as we go head into turn number three. Here comes Yancey Zimmer in the extreme top side. He'll look for the race lead off corner number four. Does he have the lead right there? And it looks like he did there. He did have the lead coming across the line to complete lap number two. And he'll take over the top spot for sure off corner number two. But here comes number four of Scott Sitterly in the high side. He's going to look to try to see if he can get up to the race lead. Through three and four, Kaylee Johnson's going to fight back on the bottom. But Zimmer holds him off as we go into turn number one. So Johnson back to spot number two. Sitterly up to spot number three. Fourth is going to look like the 69 of Chris Bachman, but he's got the Stieg in the 81 battling on the high side of him as we go into turn number three. Back in the sixth positions is 627 Harley Shepard. Seventh is Art Van Hosen, and eighth is going to be the 61 of Taylor. Right now, still Bachman going to go underneath the four of Sitterly, going through one and two as he held off the 81 of the Stieg through off corner number two. Give the three spot to Chris Bachman going into turn number three. He's going to try to hold him off. He does there, and he's going to look for a second going through turn number four. And Johnson barely hangs on as we go into turn number one. Yancey Zimmer still continues to lead the charge as we are halfway in and five to go. Johnson holds off the Punisher going off corner number two. And here comes the Stieg on the bumper of Bachman going into turn number three. He's right there on the bump. on the bumper that time, and he tried going to the high side, couldn't make it work as we go into turn number one. Behind them, Harley Shepard and Art Van Hosen battles for 6th and 7th right now. The 07 of Art Van Hosen trying to get around the 627 Harley Shepard, so far doing so. But here we go, side by side with the 4 of Scott Sitterly. He's going to get around the 81 of the Stieg. He picks up spot number 4. Now looking underneath the 69 of Chris Bachman going into turn number 3. He'll take the 3rd spot away. And now he sets his sights on the 36 of Johnson going into turn number 1 with 2 laps remaining. Bachman reels in on the 4 of Sitterly that time, but off corner number 2. Sitterly got the better run, but can he run down the 36 of Johnson going into turn number 3? White flags in the air this time by 4, the 60 of Yancey Zimmer. He'll take it into turn number 1. And still side by side for 2nd. Sitterly up high, Johnson down low. Who will it be as we gonna cross the stripe next time by? Down the back straightaway, final time into turn number 3, the 60 of Yancey Zimmer will pick up the heat race win. 2nd will go to the 36 of Johnson. 3rd is gonna be Sitterly. 4th is gonna be Chris Bachman. 5th, the Stieg. 6th will be the 627 Harley Shepard. Irvin Hosen will get the 7th spot, and Taylor in the 61 will complete the modified heat race field. So up next will be heat race number 2 for the modifieds. So here we go, heat race number 2 for the Lindsey Giagni State Farm Insurance Modifieds. And on poles, the 21 of Harry Bull to the outside of him in the 16OZ, that is Jamie West. Row 2 is going to be the 33R of Mr. Promoter Luke Rakoske. To the outside of him is the Hard Charger 09 of Tom Diamond. Row number 3 is going to be the 43 of Larry Breckenridge Jr. on the inside. To the outside of him in the 18, that is Kyle Morris. Super Squad Israel Perez and the 9 will round out the field as we go green with heat race number 2. Into turn number 3, it's going to look like Mr. Promoter Luke Rakoske will come around corner number 4. He'll lead lap number 1. Harry Bull's going to challenge on the high side through turn number 1. 3 wide towards the back is between Israel Perez, Breckenridge, and Diamond as we go through turn number 2. And Israel Perez gets the benefit out of that one as we head into turn number 3. Rakoske's going to come around corner number 4. He will lead lap number 2. Jamie West looks like he'll move up to spot number 2. But here comes Harry Bull on the high side. He's going to get a little push from the 09 of Tom Diamond through the front stretch into turns 1 and 2. Harry Bull holds off the 16OZ of West off corner number 2. And can he do so through 3 and 4? We'll find out. As they're still side by side, Jamie West holds on for that 2nd spot, but still side by side behind Luke Rakoske throughout the rest of the field. And now Jamie West takes over the 2 spot, but here comes Israel Perez in the number 9. He's going to look to take the 3rd spot away from the 21 of Perry Bull going into turn number 3. Tom Diamond right there on the corner panel makes Harry Bull bobble up there. As we go into turns 1 and 2, that's going to cost Tom Diamond the 0-9 now. And side by side, once again throughout the rest of the field, all behind the race leader of Luke Rakoske. But meanwhile, Jamie West holds off the 9 of Perez off corner number 4, and he'll hold on for spot number 2 as Perez sits back for 3rd. Kyle Morris now moves up to the 4th spot. Tom Diamond now going to look underneath the 21 of Harry Bull. He'll try to take the 5th spot away going into turn number 3. Breckenridge in the 43 sits quietly from the 7th spot. And he'll follow suit with Tom Diamond, the 09, as Harry Bull started on pole. And it's going to look like he'll go all the way back to the tail end of the field. Through 1 and 2, Israel Perez tried getting underneath the 16OZ of Jamie West. Going to go for the 2nd spot, but can't quite make it stick through there. But he'll try once again through turns 3 and 4. And Perez couldn't make it work as Jamie West held him off. And here comes Kyle Morris on the outside in turn number 4. Now through turns 1 and 2. Perez holds on to the bottom as we go off corner number 2 down the backstretch into turn number 3. 2 laps will remain this time by as the 33R Mister Promoter Luke Rakoske trying to hang on for the race lead as we go through turns 1 and 2. He has a lead for the time being, but can he hold on for the race win here with the Another lap and a half remaining in this heat. Through turns 3 and 4, he will see the white flag this time by one more time around for Mr. Promoter. Rakoske is holding on for that one as we go through turns 1 and 2. Here comes Jamie West in the 16OZ. As we go into turns 3 and 4 for the final time, Jamie West is going to throw it up to the high side. Can't quite make a stick as Mr. Promoter picks up the win. Jamie West for second, Israel Perez third, Kyle Morris fourth, Tom Diamond fifth, Breckenridge sixth, and Harry Bull completes the field. So up next will be our final heat race of the evening, the More to Music Adult Prepared Heat Race number 2. Alrighty, final heat race for the night and for the Sim Series racing action. On pole is going to be the 11 of Kyle Wilfred, and the outside of him in the 23, that's Draven Farnham. Harley Shepard in the 627 on the inside of row number 2 with the 717 of Dustin Chapman to the outside of him. Noah Dwister in the number 30 will start inside row number 3, and the 24 end of Nathan Orman will complete the field. So once again, these guys will go around for another 10-lap heat to figure out their average finish to determine the starting lineup for the 20-lap main event later on tonight. Green flags in the air as we go through turns 1 and 2. First time, it's going to look like Draven Farnham and Kyle Wilford battle and out side by side down the backstretch heading into turn number 3. Harley Shepard is going to be right out tagging on the back bumper of the 11 of Wilford through 3 and 4. He's going to back out of that one, and Twister's going to be right on the bumper of Shepard. And lap number 1 is going to go to Kyle Wilford as he just edged out the 23 of Draven Farnham. But Farnham gets a huge run on the high side through turn number 2. He'll take over the race lead going into turn number 3. And here we go, side by side for 3rd and 4th. But here comes Dustin Chapman way up to the top side. He'll take over the 3rd spot. Harley Shepard down low, going to look for that 3rd spot through turn number 2. Can't quite make it stick that time as Chapman holds him off for the spot on the high side, but Shepard's going to make it work on the bottom. He'll take over 3rd and look for more. He'll go 2 positions through 3 and 4, and he's up to spot number 2 now, but Kyle Wilford's trying to answer back on the high side. Can't quite make it stick, and he actually just might through turn number 2. As Shepard bobbled up a little bit, and here comes Wilfred on the top side through turns 3 and 4. Wilfred is going to take over the 2 spot. So Draven Farnham continues to lead the charge in the number 23. Kyle Wilfred sits there for spot number 2. Shepard back for 3rd, Chapman 4th, Twister 5th, and the 24 end of Nathan Orman sits there in spot number 6. Here comes Shepard on the bottom, going to look for the second spot through the corners. He's going to try to make his stick on the inside of turns 1 and 2. He'll take over the 2 spot off corner number 2. But Kyle Wilfred's not giving up without a fight going down the backstretch into turn number 3. Kyle Wilfred's going to try to send it on the top side once again, but Shepard might have held on better that time on the bottom off turn number 4. Wilfred's going to try to get the outside to work through corner number 2. He does. He'll take the spot back off corner number 2. This is the battle of the race so far, and Shepard's going to go once again, going to look to the bottom of Wilfred. Wilfred throws a little bit of a block there off corner number 4. Wilfred's trying to hang on, but here comes Shepard once again, side by side off corner number 2. Wilfred up high, Shepard down low as Wilfred's trying to hang on for the second spot through 3 and 4. Here comes Shepard once again, trying to mix up the work. Draven Farnham's going to come around turns 3 and 4 to look for the white flag this time by Draven Farnham, continues to lead the way. Farnham off corner number 2, down the backstretch into turn number 3. Final time, it's going to be the 23 of Draven Farnham picking up the heat race win. Second's going to go to Kyle Wilfred, Harley Shepard third, Chapman fourth, and Dwister just holds off the 24 on Nathan Orman for the 5th spot, and Orman completes the field. So now we'll see our first 50-lap feature, but it's going to come from the Rakoske Small Engine Repair Enduros. Don't go anywhere, folks. Okay, the final enduro feature for the 518 LMRO Sim Series season. And I'm pulling this one. It's a double zero. Matt O'Hanley to the outside of him is a 1K of Corey Bachman. And it's Steve McPhee in the X59 inside row two with a 46 of Paul Rakoske to round out your starting grid. Matt O'Hanley sits 5 points behind the 1K of Corey Bachman. They are the only two that can win this championship mathematically. So here we go. Who's it going to be? As we go green flag racing with the Rakoske Smudge Repair Enduros. Down the backstretch into turn number three. First time is going to be Matt O'Hanley leading the charge. But here comes Hickey to the inside looking for the lead off corner number four. O'Hanley leads of lap number one. Hickey down low looking for the lead as we go through turns one and two. Hickey's got to buy a nose as we come off corner number two. Side by side drag race down the backstretch into turn number three. Give the race lead to the X59 of Steve Hickey. He'll come off corner number four. New race leader. Hickey leads right now with Matt O'Hanley sitting for spot number two. Third is the 46 of Paul Rakoske with Corey Bachman rounding out the field. How the points breakdown works is the winner gets 20 points, second gets 17, third gets 15, and then 13 for fourth. So right now, if the race finishes out as we speak, Matt O'Hanley would not win the championship. Matt O'Hanley has to win, and Bachman needs to finish last in order for this to happen. Or Matt O'Hanley could win, and then Bachman could finish third, and we'll play out the tiebreakers from there. But right now, as we stand, O'Hanley will not win the championship. He'll fall just short. But right now, it is Steve Hickey in the X59. He'll come around turns three and four. And he'll lead lap number six as he starts to pull away from the double zero. Matt O'Hanley, Paul Rakoske in the 46. Right there for spot number three. And Corey Bachman in the 1K rounds out the rest of your field right now. But as we speak at the moment with the points, once again, Matt O'Hanley will fall just short of by 1 point. But Steve Hickey will tie Corey Bachman, but Bachman will edge him on the tiebreaker. The tiebreaker that I'm talking about will be how many feature wins. So if Matt O'Hanley were to finish first, Corey Bachman can finish third or fourth for O'Hanley to win the championship. But if O'Hanley sits in the second spot, it's not going to help him any. So right now, Corey Bachman is looking at clinching the Enduro Championship right now as we are working on lap number 10 of this 50-lap Enduro featured to round out the 518 LMRO Sim Series. Steve Hickey continues to lead the charge as we're a fifth of the way through this feature. O'Hanley's trying to rail in that X59 machine as he knows he's got to get a win to help him clinch the championship. Paul Rakoske in the 46 right there for spot number three all by himself. He's trying to rail in the double zero of O'Hanley. But Steve Hickey right now just running very strongly, smooth and consistent through three and four. Hickey looking for his first feature win of the Sim Series racing action. As O'Hanley right there for spot number two, Rakoske in the 46 also looking for his first feature win, but he's got a lot of ground to make up, but there's a lot of time to reel in. I would say Steve Hickey right now is about half a lap ahead of the 1K of Corey Bachman, which for Matt O'Hanley, that is not really good because O'Hanley's got to reel in that X59 machine. As Hickey will come around turns 3 and 4 here, he will lead 15 laps into the books. So Matt O'Hanley has 2 feature wins. He won on opening night and then last week, actually. So Matt O'Hanley is the opening night feature winner and most recent feature winner as we speak right now. And then the 1K of Corey Bachman won weeks 2 and 3. And Paul Rakoske and Steve Hickey have not gotten the feature wins yet, but Steve Hickey looking for feature win number 1 here tonight. On championship finale night. As we're gonna start watching that gap because, again, O'Hanley needs to win with Bachman finishing 3rd or 4th. And right now, O'Hanley in the double 0 sits a little under 3 seconds behind, which is not what he wants right now. So as we speak right now, Hickey and Paul Rakoske are 7 points back, which from 1st to 4th in a feature race is a 7-point difference. But however, Hickey and Rakoske would not be able to win the championship, being that O'Hanley and Corey Bachman have won more features, and they would beat both of them in the tiebreaker if it were to come down to it. But right now as we speak, if we were to finish exactly like this, Corey Bachman would be your championship, would win the Enduro Championship. He would tie Steve Hickey, but he wins on the tiebreaker for a number of feature wins. And Steve Hickey would finish in 2nd, who's coming closer to the 1K of Corey Bachman right now to put him down a lap. But Steve Hickey would finish 2nd in points. And then Matt O'Hanley would drop to 3rd, 1 point back. And then Rakoske in the 46, unfortunately, would finish in the 4th position in the Enduro Points Championship. So Steve Hickey in the X59 continues to lead the charge. A little over 3 seconds on the 00 of O'Hanley, as we're now going to come around 3 and 4, just one lap short from the halfway point here. O'Hanley for spot number 2, Rakoske in the 46 for spot number 3, and Corey Bachman completes the field as Hickey's running down that 1K machine of Corey Bachman. Hickey in the X59 off quarter number 2, halfway in, 25 down and 25 to go. He has a little over 3.5 second lead on the 00 of O'Hanley. Make the gap just over 3 seconds. So O'Hanley got the better lap there. Question's going to be, when Hickey catches up to Bachman, will O'Hanley be able to reel him in? And we're going to watch the gap once again. It's now 3 seconds. O'Hanley reeling in. About 0.5 second in the last 2 laps on the X59 of Steve Hickey. So O'Hanley may have found something here. Or Steve Hickey's fading away. About another 0.25 second gained on the X59 for Matt O'Hanley. He could be catching him. As we're gonna have almost 20 laps remain in this Enduro feature. And O'Hanley's down to 2.5 seconds. 20 laps to go this time. 30 laps in for the Rakoske Small to Repair Enduros. Steve Hickey still leads the charge. O'Hanley is now reeled in to about a little over 2.25 seconds on the X59 of Steve Hickey. At one point, he was 3.5 seconds back. He's gained a second on him in the few laps. Well, that time Hickey got the better lap. O'Hanley trying to reel in that X59 machine to try to clinch a championship. See what the gap is this time by. O'Hanley now down to 2.25. Rakoske in the 46 sits quietly from third. Bachman still trying to hold off the X59 of Steve Hickey, keep a good distance from him so he doesn't go down a lap. And Steve Hickey's now 2 seconds behind the X59 of Steve Hickey. Matt O'Hanley trying to catch him as he's really getting a run through 3 and 4 by the looks of it. And now the gap is just over 1.5 seconds. We could be seeing a battle for the lead and for the championship heat up. Fifteen laps to go in this Enduro feature. O'Hanley just under 2 seconds from the X59 of Hickey. He has 15, now make it 14 laps to go to get around the X59 machine. What does he have left? Well, that time O'Hanley lost track of the X59 of Steve Hickey. And Corey Bachman just stops on the backstretch. That's going to bring out the yellow. So something going on with the 1K of Bachman there. So this completely changes everything. Bachman might have a mechanical problem or something happened with the 1K machine. And I do believe this will be the first yellow of Sim Series Racing Competition. So, this will bring the field back together as Steve Hickey in the X59 will be the leader. Matt O'Hanley second, Paul Rakoske third, Corey Bachman in the fourth position, one lap down. Championship implications. Bachman in the 1K. Looks like he will finish the race in fourth with one lap down. Now the question's going to be, where will Matt O'Hanley finish? Right now, O'Hanley falls 1 point short, with Hickey tying Bachman at the moment, but Bachman gets the championship via a tiebreaker on feature wins. So they're all going to line up single file, and I believe here in NR2003, in this virtual sim here, caution laps do count. That's one thing. And then the lap down cars will start on the inside of the lead lap cars. So lights on the pace truck have turned off. We're going to go back to green next time by. And looks like we're just going to stay single file on this restart. Bachman will just join the tail end of the field. So here we go. Going through turns 3 and 4, we are going to have 9 laps remaining in this Rakoske Small Engine Repair Enduro feature. Steve Hickey will lead the green as we come down to the cones, and green flags back out. 9 laps to go in this Enduro feature. Down the back straightaway into turn number 3. Steve Hickey still leads the charge. Does Matt O'Hanley have anything left in the closing laps? Off corner number 4, Steve Hickey bridges himself a small gap. O'Hanley gets away from Rakoske. He reels in on the X59 of Steve Hickey through turn number 2. Down the back stretch, heading into turn number 3, Hickey still trying to hold off the double zero of O'Hanley. O'Hanley gets a run off 3 and 4. He's right there as we go into turn number 1 here with 7 laps remaining. Through turns 3 and 4, Hickey bridging himself more of a gap on the double zero of O'Hanley. 6 laps to go. O'Hanley in the double zero trying to make something work. As we head off corner number 2 down the backstretch, O'Hanley trying to get a run going here. The challenge for the lead. 5 laps remaining here in the Enduro feature. Steve Hickey looking for his first feature win of the Sim Series season. O'Hanley trying to catch up to him to win a championship. As we go into turn number 3. 4 laps remain for the SNH Bicycle Store X59 of Steve Hickey. As we go into turn number 1. O'Hanley sits there for spot number 2. Paul Rakoske for 3rd. And Corey Bachman, 1 lap down, sits in the 4th spot. And whatever happened during that caution to make him stop on the backstretch, must have been like a small little engine fail or something, I don't know, but he seems to be running fine now. Steve Hickey down the backstretch into turn number 3. He will come around turn number 4 with 2 laps to go this time by. O'Hanley has to find something. He doesn't have much time left. Through turns 1 and 2. White flag this time for the X59 of Steve Hickey. A championship on the line here as we gum off corner number 2 for the final time in the Sim Series Enduro Racing action. In turns 3 and 4, Steve Hickey will pick up the Enduro feature win. Matt O'Hanley will finish in 2nd. 3rd is going to be Paul Rakoske, and your 2020 Sim Series champion for the Rakoske Small Engine Repair Enduros is the 1K of Corey Bachman. So congratulations to Corey Bachman for winning the Sim Series racing action for the Enduros in the points championship. So we're going to take a brief intermission, and then we'll come back with 3 more features for you with the 520 LMRO Predators, Mortem Music, Adult Prepared, and our 50 lap Lindsey Giagni State Farm Insurance Modifieds. So go ahead, get up, stretch your legs, do what you got to do. We'll be right back with more feature racing. Enjoy the intermission.
I'll be the last one standing, 2 hands in the air, I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle, I'm a soldier. Yeah, I'm a fighter like Rocky. Put your flag on your back like Ali. Yeah, I'm the greatest, I'm stronger. Bet my dues, can't lose, I'm my own, yeah. Unbreakable.
for the glory, but don't think that I did it for the fame, yeah. I did it for the love of the game, yeah. And this is my chance I'm taking. All them old records I'm breaking. All your people watching on the TV, you go ahead and put your bets on me.
For the courage I possess through the drama. H is for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start. They say that every champion is all about his principles. Carry.
Chance, and it's worth taking. Get on.
518 LMRO Predator Racing action for the final time in Sim Series action. And on pole for this one is the Wonder Woman 9R Ava Rakoske to the outside of her in the 14 that is Chase Fisher. Row 2 on the inside is your official Predator Sim Series champion, Aaron Rakoske, the 33 AR to the outside of him is the 32 of Karsten Diamond. 428T of Tanner Bean on the inside of Roto Capri with the 24R of Gail Rakoske to the outside of him. Here's Rakoske in the 20R and James Kerr on the 55. Round out the field. We are green for Predator action. Down the backstretch into turn number 3, first time. It's gonna be side-by-side racing action. We're gonna see 3 wide for Jael, Tanner, and Tirza going into turn number 1. And it's gonna be Chase Fisher leading that lap as we come off corner number 2. He'll take over the lead. Side-by-side with Ava and Carson through turn number 3. Aaron's trying to get around the 9R of Ava Rakoske, but can't quite make it work as we come off corner number 4, and Chase Fisher will lead another lap. Still side by side from second on back to the 7th spot, and James Carroll rounds out the field in 8th. Karsten Diamond gets the outside of work. He'll take over the 2 spot. Now go to the extreme top side, trying to get around the 14 of Chase Fisher. Fisher tried blocking the 9 off Ava. He got it to work for the time being as we come off into turns 1 and 2. Aaron Rakoske, whoa boy, bobbles up there as we come down the backstretch into turn number 3. Here comes Jael Rakoske in the top sign in the 24R. Aaron Rakoske's going to thread the needle in the middle to make it 3 wide down the front stretch into turn number 1. Aaron's going to try to make it work. He does off corner number 2. Give him the 3rd spot, but don't sleep on it for long because here comes Ava on the bottom in the 9R. She's going to try to challenge and stick with him off corner number 4. Can't quite make it work. Aaron up to the spot number 3. Going to try to chase down the 32 of Karsten Diamond and the 14 of Chase Fisher. Your top 2 as we go on to turn number 3. Karsten Diamond's going to look to go underneath the 14 of Chase Fisher. He'll do so through 3 and 4. Off the corner, Chase Fisher will lead by a nose. We head down the front stretch, going into turn number 1. Karsten down low, Chase up high. Who's it going to be? Side by side, drag race off corner number 2. Chase Fisher prevails on the high side off turn number 2. Into turn number 3, Carson's going to look underneath once again through 3 and 4. Off the corner, it's going to be Chase Fisher once again with the lead at the line. Carson now takes over the race lead off corner number 2, but here comes Chase Fisher to answer back. Drag race down the backstretch into turn number 3. Give the lead to the 32 of Karsten Diamond. Looking to end the Sim Series racing action how he started it with a feature win. And Chase Fisher moves back to spot number 2. Aaron Rakoske back to 3rd, but here comes Jael Rakoske in the 24R. She sits in the 4th spot. Tirza in spot number 5. 6th is the 9R of Ava Rakoske, James Carroll for 7th, and Tanner Bean in position number 8. And here we go, back up towards the front. Here comes JL to the inside of Aaron going into turn number 1. She's going to look to take the 3 spot away. Off corner number 2, Aaron prevails on the high side, down the backstretch going into turn number 3. Here comes JL once again on the bottom through 3 and 4. Off the corner, it's going to be Aaron prevailing on the high side and trying to hold off for the 3rd spot. Still side-by-sides, we are halfway in, 10 down and 10 to go in this Predator feature. Down into turn number 3, JL is going to look underneath the 33 AR of Aaron Rakoske, still going back and forth for the 3rd spot. Aaron prevails on the high side, now he'll keep the high side train working as he's going to try to challenge a 14 of Chase Fisher, couldn't make it work, but here comes JL on the bottom of 1 and 2. JL is going to take over the 3rd spot off quarter number 2, but Aaron's going to answer back through 3 and 4 on the high side. And here he comes, can't make it stick, but here comes JL going to try to challenge a 14 of Chase Fisher through turn number 1. She's going to try to take the 2nd spot away, but Chase Fisher prevails on the high side through 1 and 2. JL trying to hang on as we go down the back stretch into turn number 3. She's going to challenge for the 2 spot. Here we go, into turn number 3, down low. JL takes over the 2 spot. Here she comes off corner number 4. JL moves up to spot number 2. Moving Chase Fisher back to third as Carson's starting to walk away with this feature race as we complete lap number 14. Aaron's back to spot number four. Fifth is the 20-yard of tiers of this James Carroll and Tanner Bean with Ava Rakoske to round out the rest of your field. Here comes Aaron Rakoske, throw a blanket almost on the from second to third and fourth. Aaron's going to try to run down the 14 of Chase Fisher. He'll look underneath through turns three and four. Chase Fisher's going to look to the high side of JL. Can't quite make it work. Side by side down the front stretch into turn number one. Aaron's looking down low on the 14 of Chase Fisher. Here comes Chase Fisher. He'll shot up, be shot off a cannon down the high side off corner number two. He'll try to take this two spot away as we go into turn number three. Staying on the high side there. JL's still on the bottom. Off corner number four. JL still has a spot by a nose. They come across a stripe. Aaron's trying to give a push to JL right now. JL's going to benefit from it. And here comes Aaron Rakoske. He'll go into spot number three. Getting around the 14 of Chase Fisher down the backstretch into turn number three. What's he going to do now? So he tries to get around the 24 of JL Rakoske. He'll go to his famed high side. And he'll try to take the two spot away going into turns one and two. Three laps remain this time by as Aaron Rakoske still side by side with JL off corner number two down the backstretch into turn number three. Aaron's going to try to take the two spot away as we come around to corner number four. He will do so by a nose as we come across a stripe. But JL's going to answer back on the bottom through turns one and two. Aaron's going to come off the corner with the momentum and he'll take over spot number two. White flags in the air for the 32 of Carson Diamond. He started the Predator division in the Sim Series with a feature win, and he'll look to end it the same way here tonight. Down the back stretch, going into turn number three, final time. The 32 Diamond performances of Karsten Diamond will pick up the feature win. Second, we'll go to the 33 AR of Aaron Rakoske, JL for fourth, or third. Fourth is Chase Fisher, just holding off the 20 of tiers of Rakoske as she finishes in fifth. Tanner for sixth, James Carroll seventh, and Ava Rakoske rounds out the remainder of your field. So again, before tonight's racing action, Aaron Rakoske officially clinched the Predator Sim Series Championship. So he will be your Predator Sim Series Champion. And now we get ready for 20 laps of Mortal Music Adult Prepared feature. Final feature for your Mortal Music Entertainment Karaoke Adult Prepared. Now pull for this one as the Diamond Performance is number 23 of Graven Farnham to the outside of him. Your official Sim Series Prepared Points Champion, the 30th, Andy Nordwister. Well, to the inside could be the 24 end of Nathan Orman and the 627 of Harley Shepard to the outside of him. Row 3 is the 717 of Dustin Chapman with the 11 of Kyle Wilford to round out your field. And here we go, green flags in the air. We're racing for the final time with the adult prepared. In a turn number three, Draven Farnham gets a huge start and a huge jump. He'll come around turn number four. He'll lead lap number one. Sit there for spot number two, side by side with Dwister and Orman through turns one and two. Orman looks like he'll have it off corner number two. Side by side drag race as we go into turn number three. Orman's going to look to take the two spot, but Dwister's still on the high side as we come off turn number four and give the spot to Dwister by a bumper as we come across the line. Orman answers back on the bottom. He'll take over spot number two. Now he'll try to challenge the 23 of Draven Farnham off corner number four. And here we go, and off corner number two, I should say, through turns three and four. Now, Draven Farnham still continues to lead the way. Orman's still right there, but here comes Dwister once again on the high side off corner number four. He'll try to make that work. Dwister coming off a three-race streak of winning right now. He's going to try to get spot feature win number four, but no need for it because Dwister's already the adult prepared points champion. And Nathan Orman, oh boy, in the 24N. He was second. Now look back to going back to fourth. And he's trying to hold off the 717 of Dustin Chapman. But here comes, as Chapman gets by, here comes the 11 of Kyle Wilford that will join the 717 machine. And Twister's going way up to the top side. He'll try to challenge the 23 of Farnham as we go into turn number one. Through turns one and two, Farnham down low, Twister up high, and it's going to look like Twister will have the race lead down the backstretch into turn number three. Twister going to make it four in a row, but like I said, he doesn't need to. He could finish last and still be the champion here because he's already that far ahead. As we go into turns one and two, Farnham holds him off on the inside through turn number one, and he'll try to pull away from 30 of Twister as we come down the backstretch. Meanwhile, side by side with the 11 of Wilfred and the 717 of Dustin Chapman. Wilfred on low as we go through three and four. He's trying to get the third spot. Chapman trying to hold him off as we come across the line. And Wilfred takes the third spot away. Now he's underneath the 30 of Twister going into turn number two. Looking for the two spot down the backstretch as we head into turn number three. Wilfred down low, Twister up high, side by side as we come off corner number four. Wilfred picks up spot number two. He's now going to look for the race lead going into turn number one. What does he have for the number 23 of Farnham as we go through turn number two? Wilfred is on the bumper of Farnham as we go into turn number three. Which lane is he going to choose to challenge for the lead? He's going to challenge here through three and four. He's right there. Configured bump draft with him right for that time. As we go into turns one and two, as Twister and Chapman trying to get into the mix as well for this race lead, trying to make it a four-car battle. But here we go, coming off turns three and four. We are seeing the halfway signal. 10 down, 10 to go. So Farnham continues to lead the charge with Wilfred sitting there for spot number two. Twister right there for third as Chapman sits there for spot number four. Nathan Norman and Harley Shepard in fifth and sixth to round out the field. Here comes Twister on the high side in turns three and four. He'll try to challenge the 11 of Wilfred for the second spot and can't make his stick as here comes Wilfred. He'll try to pull away from the 30 of Twister. Now he's trying to get a run on the 23 of Farnham. He's right there on the bumper going into turn number three down the backstretch. He's going to look to the inside through turns three and four. Kyle Wilfred trying to sneak in there. And it's still Farnham for the lead as we come across the stripe. Wilfred's right there, down low through turns one and two. Can Wilfred make it work? He does off quarter number two. New race leader, it's the 11 of Kyle Wilfred going into turn number three. Seven laps to go this time by for the 11 of Kyle Wilfred as he comes into turns one and two. Down low, looking for seconds, the 30 of Twister. He'll look to get by the 23 of Farnham. He does through turns one and two. Farnham's going to try to challenge once again on the high side and make sure he keeps fighting for that spot. Through turns three and four, Draven Farnham has the two spot back off corner number four. Twister still fighting low through turns one and two. He'll take the two spot back, but Draven's going to answer back in the high side off corner number two, down the back stretch, drag race into turn number three. Who's it going to be as we come around turns three and four? Looks like Twister will have the best of this battle off corner number four. He'll have position number two. Twister still challenging on the bottom, Draven up high. Draven takes over the two spot off corner number two on the high side. As we're now going to have four laps remaining for the number 11 of Kyle Wilfred, looking for his first feature win. Harley Shepard won on opening night, then it was Noah Twister for the next three nights, and Wilfred looking to end the season on a high note with a win as we come into turns three and four. Three laps to go this time by for the 11 of Wilfred. Farnham right there for spot number two with Twister hot on his bumper from spot number three. Chapman in the 717 sits there for spot number four. Nathan Orman in the five spot with Harley Shepard around out the field. Two laps remain this time by for the 11 of Kyle Wilfer as he heads into turns one and two. There's a huge gap between him and second place of the 23 of Draven Farnham. Is about a whole straightaway lead as he comes around turns three and four. He will see the white flag one more time around. Kyle Wilfred heads off turn number two down the back straightaway into turns three and four. Final time Kyle Welfer will pick up the adult prepared feature win. Second will go to Graven Farnham. Nordwister third, Dustin Chapman fourth. Nathan Orman will cross the line in fifth with Harley Shepard in the 627, rounding out the field in the sixth position. So that leaves one more feature left to go. As like we said earlier, Nordwister is the Immortal Music Adult Prepared Points Champion for the Sim Series. And now one more feature left. Your 50 lap Lindsey Giagni State Farm Insurance Modified.
Time to play the game. Time to play the game.
Okay, here we go. Your final feature for the Sim Series action for your Modified. Well, they will line up for tonight's 50-lap main event. Starting in spot number 15, inside row number 8. In car number 61, it is Taz Taylor. 14th starting spot, outside row number 7. In car number 21, it is Harry Bull. To the inside of him is Mr. Mo Fasta, Art Van Hosen, in car number 07, in the 13th starting spot. Six on the outside, row starting spot. And the number 43, that is Larry Breckenridge Jr. To the inside of him. And the 11th starting spot, that is the 627 of Harley Shepard. Top 10 starters outside, row number 5, and the 10th starting spot. In the number 09, that is Tom Diamond. To the inside of him. And the 9th starting spot, the 81 of the Steam. Number 4 on the outside, 8th starting spot, in the Camel sponsor, number 18, that is Kyle Morris. To the inside of him. And the 7th starting spot is the 69 of the Punisher, Chris Bachman. Outside, row number 3. 6th starting spot in the Super Squad. Number 9, it is Israel Perez to the inside of him. And the number 4, that is Scott Sitterly, starting in spot number 5. Row number 2 on the outside. 4th starting spot is the 16 OZ of Jamie West to the inside of him. In car number 36 in the 3rd starting spot, that is Kaylee Johnson. And now your front row starters in the 33R, that is Luke Rakoske, Mr. Promoter. He'll start the outside front row to the inside of him. On pole is the number 60 of NC Zimmer. How they will line up for tonight. So they'll line up for tonight's 50 lap main event championship night finale. So, for the final time in Sim Series Racing Competition, it's your main event of the evening, the show you've been waiting for, 2x2 all the way through. We're going to send it up quarter number 4 with your Lindsey Giagni State Farm Insurance Modified. Through turns 3 and 4, first time, it's going to be side-by-side with Yancey Zimmer and Kaylee Johnson, your top two in the points championship right now. Yancey Zimmer led the lap as we go through turns 1 and 2. He's on the high side trying to hold off the 36 of Johnson. He'll do so off corner number 2, down the back straightaway. In the turn number 3, Zimmer's still holding off the 36 of Johnson, but Johnson's going to look underneath on corner number 4, and he will try to lead that time. He will do so by a nose as we go into turn number 1. Here comes Scott Sitterly in the number 4. He's up to spot number 3. He got around the number 9 of Israel Perez as we go into turns 3 and 4. Sitterly's trying to get more positions but can't quite do so. He might thread the needle in the middle of those of Johnson and Zimmer, but backs out of it as we go into turn number 1. Zimmer and Johnson still battling out side by side. Johnson still holding on as we go down the back stretch into turn number 3. Johnson's going to want to take the lead. He'll do so in turn number 3. Kaylee Johnson, now your new race leader. the four of Scott Sitterly now moves into spot number two as we go into turn number one, putting Yancey Zimmer back to third. Israel Perez sits there for fourth, Bachman for fifth, Rakoske sixth, Harley Shepard for seventh, make that Kyle Morris seventh, Shepard eighth, Taylor ninth, and Jamie West round out the field. We're all going three wide, going crazily nuts. The 43 of Larry Breckenridge having some early race issues here. He's currently two laps down now. And Sitter lead now gets underneath the 36 of Johnson. He'll take over the race lead on the completion of lap number six. Down the back straightaway into turn number three. Sitterly still leads the charge. Johnson back for spot number two. Yancey Zimmer is still there for third. Right now, as we speak, Johnson and Zimmer are tied for the points championship. Zimmer was only 2 points ahead of Kaylee Johnson, but they're tied for the championship, and it would come down to a tiebreaker. Which it wouldn't be based on feature wins because they have the same amount of feature wins right now. So we'll look deeper and deeper as we keep on going. Hang on, look at this! From the 15th starting spot, car number 61, Taz Taylor trying to go from last to first deep in the field. He's now worked his way around the 69 of Chris Bachman as we go through turns three and four. He's now up into position number five. So right now, Breckenridge down three laps, so he's back in the 15th spot. But right now, Scott Sitterly walking away from the rest of the field. He's your current race leader. Second, yo, Johnson bobbles up three, wide off corner number four. And Perez is going to take the second spot on the high side and prevails out of that three-wide situation. He'll take over spot number two as Johnson now back to third. Zimmer to fourth. Van Hosen now up to fifth. Taylor sixth. Seventh is Bachman. Eighth is going to be Jamie West. Rakoske for ninth. And Morris rounds out your top 10. Shepard 11th. Harry Bull 12th. Tom Diamond 13th. And the Steeg 14th with Breckenridge round out your field. Sitterly into turn number three by himself with the lead. Perez in the spot number two. Zimmer's now in the third, now looking underneath Perez for the second spot. As we keep on going into turn number one, right now as we speak points-wise, the 60 of Yancey Zimmer will be your champion as we speak, as long as he stays ahead of that 36 car of Kaylee Johnson. So the points battle heading into tonight. Zimmer with the points lead of 68 points. Kaylee Johnson was second, 2 points back. Harry Bull third, 3 points behind. And then Jamie West was mathematically, and so was the Steeg in fourth and fifth, but they had a bigger margin to try to make up. Luke Rakoske needed a feature win to try to at least see if a tiebreaker would favor him for a points championship, but right now, that's not looking so well. So Scott Sitterly continues to lead the charge. Van Hosen for second. Perez sits there for third. Fourth is now the 61 of Taylor. Fifth is Yancey Zimmer. Sixth is Kaylee Johnson. Seventh is the 16 OZ of Jamie West. Chris Bachman right there for spot number eight. Harley Shepard has ninth. Tenth is Luke Rakoske, but here comes Harry Bull from the 11th spot. 12th is Kyle Morris, 13th Tom Diamond, 14th the Steeg, and Larry Breckenridge Jr. rounds out the field in the 43 machine, currently three laps down. We're going to be completing lap number 19. Sitterly walking away. He's got a little over 4 seconds on the 07 of Mr. Mo Fasta. And here comes Taylor in the 61. He's underneath the 9 of Perez, going to the turns 1 and 2, looking for the third spot. He'll have it off quarter number 2. Perez now moves back to 4th as Johnson's now ahead of the 60 of Yancey Zimmer. Question's going to be, how's this going to affect the points bet at the moment? But here we go. We'll keep a very close eye on this one. As Johnson in the 36 currently has a fifth spot. Yancey currently sits in the seventh position, which is a 2-point gap amongst those two positions. So it's currently tied. And Yancey doesn't want to lose more positions because Harry Bull, he's going to be right there with him. In turns 3 and 4. It is still the 36 of Kaylee Johnson continuing, trying to win a championship. The 60 of Yancey Zimmer, trying to get around the 16 OZ of Jamie West so he can stay close with this 36 machine. Sitterly still walking away from this one. As we go into turns 3 and 4, he will see one lap short from the halfway point here. Sitterly continues to lead the way. Van Hosen for second, Taylor for third, Perez in fourth. Johnson in fifth, Jamie West in sixth. Seventh is Harley Shepard. Eighth is Yancey Zimmer. Ninth is Harry Bull, with Chris Bachman in the top 10. Kyle Morris 11th, Rakoske 12th, Diamond 13th, Astig 14th, with Breckenridge round out the field as we speak, as we are officially halfway in. 25 down, 25 to go. Van Hosen trying to run down that number 4 machine from the 2 spot. But Sitterly with a full straightaway lead right now. Perez and Taylor still going at it side by side for 3rd and 4th. Perez has a spot as we come across the line by a tire. Taylor's trying to make the outside work. He does in turn number 1. But Perez holding strong on the bottom. But Taylor's going to prevail on the top side off corner number 2. Johnson in the 36 currently trying to get around the 627 Harley Shepard. Harley Shepard holds him off as we come off the corner. So Johnson back to 7th. Yancey Zimmer back to 8th. It is a 1-point cushion in which that favors Zimmer in the points championship right now. So again, Jamie West needs some kind of help. Jamie West and the Sea need some kind of help, but right now Jamie West is more of the front runner here tonight as the Sea is way back in 14th. So it looks like his championship hopes will not happen here tonight. But the three to mainly watch is Johnson, Zimmer, and Harry Bull, as those three are separated by 3 points. As we do have 20 laps remain here, Scott Sitterly heads into turn number 3, as he did get by the 81 of the Stieg to put him down a lap. As we now have 19 laps to go. Taylor and Perez still side by side through 3 and 4. Taylor on the high side, Perez down low. And Perez now has a third spot by half a car. He'll take it completely off corner number 2, putting Taylor back to 4th. Kaylee Johnson now moves up to spot number 5. Yancey Zimmer all the way back in 8th, which is enough for the championship for Kaylee Johnson. Johnson now feeling the pressure from the 16 OZ of Jamie West, as Yancey Zimmer needs to figure out something to try to catch the 36 of the 36 machine to try to keep that battle for the points championship. Johnson again was 2 points behind Yancey Zimmer coming into tonight, and Johnson lost the position to Jamie West, putting Johnson back to spot number 6. And Yancey in the 60 is in the 8th position, which right now currently ties them in points and will come down to a tiebreaker. Johnson trying to reassure another position. Into turn number 1. He's looking underneath the 16 OZ of Jamie West. Jamie West prevails on the high side off corner number 2. Here comes a 627 Harley Shepherd on the bumper of Johnson's. We head to turn number three. Gonna look, trying to get the outside to work, but Johnson got the better on the bottom and will try to challenge Jamie West once again as we go into turn number one. So let's get a quick rundown at the moment. Scott Sitterly in the number four with the lead. Second is Art Van Hosen. Third is Israel Perez in the number nine. Taylor in the fourth spot in the 61. Jamie West in fifth. Johnson sixth. Harley Shepherd seventh. Zimmer eighth. Ninth is a battle between Rakoske and Harry Bull. As Bull has a ninth spot, Rakoske in 10th. 11th is Chris Bachman. Kyle Morris in 12th, looking for 11th. 13th is Tom Diamond. Last car on the lead lap, trying to hang on as best as he can. As here comes Scott Sitterly in the number four. The Steeg in the 81, currently in the 14th position and 15th right now. Is the 43 of Larry Breckenridge Jr. still three laps down. Ten laps to go for this modified feature. Scott Sitterly still leading the charge. Van Hosen for two. Perez for three, Taylor for four. Kaylee Johnson now picks up the five spot. Jamie West for six, Harley Shepherd for seven. Eighth is Yancey Zimmer, but here comes Rakoske in the 33R looking for that spot. He has the eighth position by a tire as they came across the line. Zimmer still trying to hold him off. He takes the eighth spot back off corner number two. Harley Shepherd now gets around the 16OZ of Jamie West. That's for a position right there. Moving him to spot number six. Jamie West back to seventh. But Jamie West is going to try to answer back on the high side, down the backstretch into turn number three. Johnson now feeling the pressure from Harley Shepherd now, which might bring in Jamie West as well. As Johnson bobbles up, gives the inside lane for Harley Shepherd. Shepherd looking underneath the 36 of Johnson into turn number three. Down the front straightaway into turns one and two. Shepherd underneath Johnson as Johnson's trying to hold off the 627 Harley Shepherd, because he knows if he holds off Shepherd, the points championship is his, but he'll have to rely on a tiebreaker and hope that he wins the championship if Shepherd gets by. Zimmer in this number 60 machine trying to reel in that 16OZ of Jamie West so he can try to keep battle with the 36 of Johnson, but Johnson still battling with Harley Shepherd and holding on strong. Sitterly in the number four right now. Will lead with three laps to go. Currently, 11 cars on the lead lap. Almost three wide by the looks of it in turns three and four. Kyle Morris got by Rakoske, and now he's going to look to get by the 60 of Yancey Zimmer. Johnson still feeling the battle from the 627 Harley Shepherd. Shepherd gets by, and now you'll look to challenge the 61 of Taylor here. But here we go. Scott Sitterly in number four sees a white flag. In turns one and two, down the back straightaway, Scott Sitterly will come around turns three and four. Sitterly will pick up the modified feature win. Second is Van Hosen. Third is right here. Going to turn three and four. It's going to be the nine of Israel Perez. Fourth is Harley Shepherd. Fifth is going to be Taylor. Keely Johnson finishes in sixth. Seventh is Jamie West. Eighth is Kyle Morris. Ninth is Yancey Zimmer. They're scoring. Yancey is eighth, Kyle Morris ninth, Rakoske 10th. So, with that being said, We're going to have to look when we scroll through the point standings. Who wins the tiebreaker? Because they have the feature wins in one apiece, but the next tiebreaker is going to be average feature finish. So, let the points scroll through, and we'll find out who your points champions are. So again, congratulations to our other class champions for tonight, for the Sim Series. Thank you everyone so much for watching the entire Sim Series racing action from week number one all the way to week five. And don't forget to follow myself on Twitter at TNT Network 61. Subscribe to TNT Motorsports Network for all your 518 LMRO action for the 2020 racing season, hopefully beyond. So with that being said, follow all of the social media for 518 LMRO and all of our sponsors. We say thank you, fans, for bearing with us during this crucial time. Hope everyone stays safe. Hope everyone enjoyed the Sim Series racing action. And we'll see you later on, hopefully at the reality track. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Have a good night.
Be the last one standing, two hands in the air, I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle, I'm a soldier. Yeah, I'm a fighter like Rocky. Put your flag on your back like Ali. Yeah, I'm the greatest, I'm stronger. Bet my dues can't lose, I'm my own, yeah.
Bets on me, hey, I've been waiting my whole